वंदे गुरुपरंपरां श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहनावतु सहनौघ्नक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। योब्रह्माणविदधाति पूर्वमेवेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुम्हदेवमात्मबुद्धि प्रकाशमुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। श्रीचिद्घनगणेश नमो वयम सुखं नित्यं सत्प्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम प्रतिष्ठानं उद्योगोद्यं बुद्धिहृदयं पारं सर्ववेदान्तं प्रत्यक्परं महः तदेव अन्नमत्तं मे निश्चिता मतिः। स्क्रीन टॉस। Are you still able to see the screen?
Yes.
Okay, something wrong here. Okay, here it be. Just do on a smaller screen. So continuing with the Panchakosha Viveka. We landed on the Vijnanamaya Kosha Khandana, whereby Vijnanamaya, considered as Atma by Kshanika Vijnanamadi, has been refuted. Anandamaya Kosha Eva Atma Iti Matam. Now this is a little difficult area because Ananda is the Swarup of Atma. Wherever the Ananda is manifest, one considers that as Atma. In Sushupti also there is an Anandamaya Kosha Ananda, which is because it is manifest. Since the mind is resolved, one does not know, but still it is manifest Ananda. And one misunderstands this as Atma. Even in Taittiriya Upanishad Panchakosha Viveka, we see the Khandana of Anandamaya as Atma, which is the Ekadeshi Vada. And Bhattamata and then others also here. Bhattamata can be considered as Ekadeshi Mata as well, although it is not a Vedanta Mata. So it's the same viewpoint of Bhattas and the some type of Vedantins, one particular type of Vedantins. Now the conclusion of the other darshanas also, Bauddha Darshana, Shunyavadis, that is also analyzed and categorized into Anandamaya Kosha as Atma, that kind of a conclusion. Whether they agree or not, their conclusion is seen as in line with the Bhattamata or Anandamaya Kosha as Atma. So analysis continues. Tatra Bhattamatam Puramimamsa Vartikakaraha Bhatta evam Aha Nahi विद्युल लेख लेखा इव आत्मा क्षणिकः। सो जस्ट लाइक द स्ट्रीक ऑफ लाइटनिंग, दैट इज हाउ क्षणिक विज्ञानवादी से द आत्मा इज कॉन्शियसनेस इज क्षणिक, बट द भट्टमत रिफ्यूट्स दैट सेइंग दैट किंतु स्थिरः आत्मा इज नॉट लाइक द विद्युत, not like a lightning, it is not shanika, it is sthira. Sa atma jada rupah prakasha rupascha aste. Sa atma jada rupah प्रकाश रूपश्च अस्ति. सो इट इज अ मिक्स, समटाइम्स जड़ा समटाइम्स प्रकाश, इट्स अ मिक्स ऑफ बोथ. व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दैट? अयम अयमस्य अभिप्राय, व्हाट इज द आइडिया देयर? सुषुप्तेः उत्थिता एवं वदति, एतावन्तं कालम अहम् जड़ः निस्संज्ञः अस्वाप्सम् इति. वन हू गेट्स अप फ्रॉम द डीप स्लीप स्टेट सेज दैट आई डिड नॉट नो एनीथिंग during the deep sleep. So far I have been sleeping like a log. I was, so log is jada. I slept like a log. And even if you called out my name, I did not know because I did not have a name then. Like a log, I did not have any name. Nissanya and as, that is how I was completely in deep sleep. Aswapsam iti. Tasmad atma jada rupa iti siddhyati. Is the Atma where to be of the nature of consciousness all the time, then I wouldn't say that I was Jada in Sushupti. I would have felt my consciousness. I did not feel it. I do not recall my being conscious. Therefore, I was Jada. Kincha Sushupta Uthitasya Smriti Rapi Bhavati. However, there is a Smriti. This is what Vedantin say. I recollect on waking up. Therefore, recollection being possible only on collection, I am Satsarupa as well as Chitsarupa. I witness nothing. To witness nothing, I have to be there. I have to be conscious. And also, to have Ananda, I need to be watching over as a witness. I have to have anubhava of that sukha which I recall on waking up. Therefore, smriti being there on waking up, there is smriti of ananda and being jada also. Ananubhutyarthe na smritir bhavet. Without experience, you cannot have memory, you cannot have recollection. Therefore, shushuptau atmaswarupat. Atma swarupa atiriktam na kinchidapi jnana sadhanam asti. In Sushupti there is no other jnana sadhana, only Atma is there because manas as a jnana sadhana is resolved, buddhi as jnana sadhana is resolved. Sushuptyanantara bhavi smritehe karanam Saushupta jnanam eva vachyam. So what is this smriti from? Since there is no jnana sadhana there, Sushuptyanantara bhavi smritehe karanam saushupta jnanam eva vachyam. There is no other jnana, but what is recollected is definitely the Atma in the Sushupti avastha. So that jnana is regarding Atma itself. In the Sushupti avastha, therefore, not preceding Sushupti, not following Sushupti, it is Saushupta Jnanam Eva. Tachya Sushupti Kalinam Jnanam Atma Swarupam Eva. There is no one else, nothing else is there. Even the Karanas are resolved, therefore, the Sushupti Kala Jnana is what? It is Atma Swarupa itself. Thereby, it has to be, since jnana is possible, it has to be chetana also. So it is jada also, chetana also. That is the idea there. Ittham atma khadyotavat prakasharupa aprakasharupascha. Jada as well as chetana. It's a mix of prakash and aprakash. Jnana rupatvat prakasharupaha. Jada rupatvat aprakasharupascha. Very clear that since jnana is there, it is has to be chetana. Therefore, ajada prakasha rupa. And since I slept like a log, therefore also aprakasha rupa and jada rupa. Anandame koshayo prakasha rupa aprakasha rupascha asti. Sushuptau chaitanya bhasa saita jnanam eva anandame kosha ityuchyate. Anandame kosha is the kosha that one associates with in Sushupti avastha. This is what everyone says. He says Sushuptau chaitanyabhasa saita jnanam. एव आनंदमयकोश तत्र चिदाभासः प्रकाशरूपा अज्ञानम् अप्रकाशरूपं च भवति. सो व्हाट इज द रियलिटी इन सुषुप्ति? देयर इज अज्ञान एंड देयर इज ज्ञान आल्सो. देयरफॉर आत्मा इज ऑफ अ मिक्स स्वरूप. व्हाट काइंड ऑफ अ मिक्स स्वरूप? चिदाभास इज प्रकाशरूप, वेर एज अज्ञान इज अप्रकाशरूप जड. तस्मात् भट्टमते आनंदमय कोश एव आत्मा इति सिद्धम. सो इफ यू एनालाइज देयर मत, सो दे डू नॉट से दैट आत्मा इज अज्ञान, दे से जड. एंड व्हेन वी एनालाइज व्हाई इज देयर अ कंफ्यूजन, सो इफ यू एनालाइज देन यू सी दैट चैतन्य आभास सहित आनंदमय कोश इज व्हाट प्रकाश रूप अप्रकाश रूपश्च अस्ति. व्हाई? बिकॉज आनंदमय इज कारण शरीर, कारण शरीर इज अज्ञान. बट अज्ञान कैनॉट linger on its own. Nothing can linger on its own. There is a basis in Chaitanya. And this Chaitanya being there is Abhasa also. Chaitanya Abhasa in Avidya itself, Ajnana. So Abhasa makes this Jnana possible and Ajnana makes the Jadatva possible. So jada jada prakasha prakasha rupa is anandamaya kosha. So their conclusion is anandamaya is atma. You cannot go any further. This is their thinking, and they say that Chaitanya Shruti also talks about the same thing. If you look at the panchamaya kosha, panchakosha viveka, there it ends with anandamaya kosha description, does not do a refutation. This is their argument. And there if you look up Bhagavan Bhashyakara's Bhashya, he says that the upasana which has been taught there, similarly with the bird, which are the wings, which is the head, which is the trunk, which is the tail. So there you see that Brahma Puchham Pratishtha. It is said that for Anandamaya, Brahma is the tail. Now you cannot have Anandamaya Kosha Upasana or analysis also, upasana or dhyana, dhai chintane. Chintana when you are doing, manana also, you cannot have a simile to ease your way out into reality where the trunk and the tail are same. You cannot have that. Trunk and tail have been talked about separately. So for everything then, finally, which is the tail which helps the bird to be steady? That is said to be Adhisthana Adhara Brahma. Therefore, Anandamaya is not Atma, it is Kosha. That is the final Kosha refutation as Atma in Taittiriya. Then what remains, which cannot be separated out, which cannot be objectified, is Atma. Therefore, what is understood by this analysis is that Anandamaya Kosha is considered as Atma due to a mistake, due to confusion. Further, the 288th Avarta says Madhyamika Bauddhamatam is what? Anandamaya Kosha Atma. This is put in brackets because they don't claim this. They don't have anything like Anandamaya Kosha. They don't talk in Shruti words all the time. They take the Shruti, they repackage it and talk in a different manner, being Nastikas. So Madhyamika Bauddhas, what do they say? They are Shunyavadis. So Shunyavadinaha Bauddhaha tu evam ahuhu. Atma Niraunshaha. Atma does not have any parts. So they say Tasmad Ekasyeva Atmanaha Prakasharupattvam Aprakasharupattvam jana ghatayata. You cannot have Prakasha Rupa Aunsha, Aprakasha Rupa Aunsha. So, Atma being one without any parts, either you say it is Prakasha Rupa or Aprakasha Rupa. Either you say it is Jada or Ajada, Chetana. You cannot have it both ways. Therefore, the Bhatta Mata is not valid. Meaning, Anandamaya Kosha, which you claim to be Atma, is not valid if it is a mix of both. Then what is it? Khadyotasya संशत्वाद एकांशः प्रकाश रूप अपरांशः अप्रकाश रूपश्च भवति न तु आत्मनः निरंशस्य विरुद्धोभय रूपत्व विरुद्ध उभय रूपवत् कथनं युक्तम्. सो यू कैन नॉट हैव अपोजिंग definitions. In the definition, you cannot have opposing attributes. Yadi ubhaya rupata siddhaye atmanah saunshattvam angikriyate tarhi saunshanam ghatadinam utpatti nasha darshanad atmanopi utpatti nashavattvam prasajyeta. And he argues with the, no, see, this is not exactly what they'll argue, meaning Buddha's do not use the Shruti as Pramana, but they use Shruti as selectively. They take up the Shruti just to argue, just to refute the others. They show that this is your Grantha and this is okay. We also use their own Mata and refute them. Pete any Puropakshi. Just give me a moment, there is some noise here. So they say that your Atma that you discuss is what? Yadi ubhaya rupata siddhaye atmanah saunshattvam angikriyate. If you accept this Atma to have aunshas, just for the sake of argument to establish that Atma is prakash rupa as well as aprakash rupa, then what will happen? Tarhi saunshanam ghatadinam utpatti nasha darshanad atmana api utpatti nashavattvam prasajyeta. Then what will happen is that your Atma, we don't have an issue. In a sense that Buddhas don't say that we have an issue. In your own analysis, you have agreed that Atma is Nitya. Having said that Atma is Nitya, if you agree that it has aunshas, then because of having aunshas itself, it will have utpatti and nasha like ghata ityadi. So ghatadinam yatha utpatti nasha bhavati tatha eva atmanah api prasajyeta. Yad utpatti nashavad vastu tad utpattehe pragurdhancha nashad asad bhavati. Then what will happen is that before the utpatti, atma wasn't there. After the nasha, atma won't be there. Thereby, you have landed on our paksha. Adyantayoho yad asat. Tanmadhye api asat bhavati. Now, this is the Karikakara saying. Karikakara has said that. But he has said it for Jagat. He has said that whatever is not there. Adavante chayannasti vartamane api tat tatha. This is Manduka, Mandukya Karika. Bhagavan Gaudapadacharya has said iti smrite hai adavante chayannasti. So he is using that against you. He says that in the beginning if something isn't there and that is not there in the end also, then in between also it isn't there. It does not have real presence because trikala baditam sat. This is your definition. If you say trikala baditam sat and still talk about that Atma as Sat, which has aunshas, prakasha rupa, aprakasha rupa, then how can it be Nitya? It cannot be Sat, it cannot be Nitya. And if you say that, you won't say, but even if you say that it is there, it can't be there because it is not there in the beginning and in the end. Therefore, utpatti nasha vat Atma will become Asat. Tasmad utpatti nashavatve atma asadrupaha bhavet. Atma is asadrupa. Tatha atma bhinnaha sarva api padartha utpatti nashavatvad asadrupa eva. So the Shunyavadi says now your atma has also been established as being of asat nature. Not really being there. Whereas the entire prapancha has already been refuted. Tatha atmabhinna sarva api. Atmabhinna sarva api padartha utpatti nashavatvad asadrupa eva. So prapancha is asat, atma is also asat. Anayaritya atma anatma rupa sakala vastu naam asadrupatvat shunyameva paramatattvam. Iti shunyavadinha madhyamika Buddhasya matam. So what does the Madhyamika say? Buddhas, they say Shunyavadis. They say that Shunyamiva paramatattvam. The reality is Shunya. Why? Because Atma is Asadrupa and Atma Bhinna Sarva Abhipadartha Asadrupa. Why? Utpatti Nashavatvad. So Utpatti Nashavatvam as a Hetu is used and they say whatever has utpatti and nasha, and this is a refutation of Madhyamika Buddhas towards the Vijnana, Kshanika Vijnanavadi also. Kshanika Vijnanavadi says utpatti and nasha because Kshanika, Vijnana, Kshanika, meaning it has utpatti and nasha. Between the Kshanas, there is nothing. So they say between the Kshanas, there is nothing, and since there is utpatti and nasha, there is nothing. Why do you say it is there in between also? Because adavante chennasti vartamanapi tattatha nasti eva, therefore shunyam. Tepi ajnana rupa anandamaya koshamyo pratipadayanti. Now the Siddhanti says, Vedanti says that they talk about shunya. What is shunya? Whether or not the Madhyamikas agree, they are considering Anandamaya Kosha as Brahma. How so? Tathahi drishtivhedena ajnanam trivhi rupaihi pratiyate. Based on the perspective, ajnana itself can be seen in three different ways. What are those? Advaita Shastra Samskara Rahitasya Jagadakarena Parinatam Ajnanam Satyatvena Pratiyate. So for Dvaitins, Vishishta Dvaitins, Prapancha is real. Why so? The same Ajnana, Avidya, appears in the form of Jagat. Since it appears in the form of Jagat, Maya, Avidya, that apparent reality is taken as real. There is no concept of Mithya. Why? Advaita Shastra Samskara Rahitatvat. Because there is no Advaita Shastra Samskara. They have studied, but they have set aside the Advaita. They have taken only the part which of the Vedas, Veda Vedanta, which is conducive to their own pre-concluded notions. They do not want to do Tatparya Nishchaya. They don't want to study through and through, taking each and every aspect of Karma Kanda as well as Jnana Kanda, especially Jnana Kanda, and considering that the Advaita Vakyas are also as real as the other. As real in the sense, they are not Arthavada. Then when you analyze which is the Tatparya, then you will know that the Upanishad Tatparya, one single Upanishad if you consider, you know that the Tatparya is Advaita. You don't have to add words. Without adding words, using Lakshana. Lakshana is fine if the direct meaning does not make sense. That is the only way to understand. But you should not add your own words or misinterpret any word by breaking all sorts of rules, not following any rule. Even not considering the dhatu as valid. In some places, they split across the word in such a manner that it makes no sense at all. Creating samasas where samasa rules do not apply are not valid. Adding something else from your own pockets. They do all of this. Why? Just to land on their own dvaita. And then they consider these Padma Purana, etc. They are also selectively. But if you do Tatparya Nishchaya analysis, Shadlinga analysis of one Upanishad, compare it across all other Upanishads, and then look at what is the Tatparya in the Puranas also, Smriti and Puranas also, you will land only in Advaita. But Advaita Shastra Samskara Rahitasya Dvaitinaha Jagad Akarana Parinatam Ajnanam Satyatvena Pratiyate. So this Ajnana from one perspective appears to be real because its Karya seems real. Advaita Shastra Anusari Yukti Kushalanam Panditanam Ajnanam Tatkaryam Jagatcha Sadasad Vilakshana Nirvachaniyatvena Anirvachaniyatvena Bhati. So Sadasad Vilakshana Nirvachaniyatvena Bhati, meaning Sad Asad Vilakshana, that is the Anirvachaniyatvam. Tena Bhati. But one who has done Tatparya Nishchaya analysis, he knows that Advaita Shastra is valid. Every Shruti, every Smriti is finally committed to reveal that Advaita Tattva. Then what about this Jagat, Ajnana and Jagat? Ajnana and Jagat, which is the Karya, Tatkarya, Ajnana Karya, is nothing but Anirvachaniya, Maya, Mithya. It is neither Sat nor Asat. So it is Sat Vilakshana and Asat Vilakshana, that is Anirvachaniya. You cannot say Idam Itham, it is Sat. Is it Sat? Please answer, is it Sat? No, I can't say it is Sat. Then say it is Asat. No, we cannot say it is Asat. Sat Chet na Badhyeta, Asat Chet na Pratiyeta. Since there is a Pratiti of Prapancha, it cannot be said to be Asat. And since there is a Badha on Jnanotpatti, it cannot be said to be Sat also. Therefore, it is Sat Vilakshana and Asat Vilakshana both. It is not Sat and Asat both. It is Sat Vilakshana and Asat Vilakshana. We cannot say it is Sat and Asat because contradictory. Sat and Asat are contradictory. So it is neither Sat nor Asat nor Sad and Asat. It is Sad and Asad Vilakshana. This is the second way that Ajnana is understood. What is the third way Ajnana is understood? Jnana Nishtam Praptasya Jivan Muktasya Vidushaha Ajnanam Tatkarincha Tuchatvena Pratiyate Tuchha Maya Tuchha Avidya. You have to bridge the gap. So people say that Prapancha is Mithya from the Paramarthika plane. That is not right. There are Advaita Acharyas who discuss like this. They say you should not say Prapancha is not there, Maya is not there. True, but only in Vyavahara you cannot make that statement. And in Paramarthika there is no possibility of statement. But if you are using the Paramarthika perspective and discussing that in Vyavaharika, then in Paramarthika there is nothing but Brahma. So you cannot talk about Maya, Maya Karya, Avidya, Avidya Karya. Therefore, for a Jnani whose perspective is Nirguna Brahma, who has Nishtha in Nirguna Brahma, there is no Maya, Maya Karya at all. So it is said, Jnana Nishtham Praptasya Jivan Muktasya. Now this is very loaded. Jnana Nishtham Praptasya, not one who is a Jnani Matra. One who has Jnana Nishtha, that kind of a Jivan Mukta, then alone he is a Jivan Mukta. That kind of a Jivan Mukta, who is a Vidwan, in the true sense of the word, for him Ajnana and its Karya, which is Jagat, Tuchatvena Pratiyate, appears as not being there. Therefore, he himself sees himself everywhere, not with the body-mind-sense complex. The body-mind-sense complex also is resolved to being Mithya in the Sadhana Avastha, as a Sadhaka. After Jnanotpatti, it does not exist at all. Tuchham is what? Asat. So, starting with Sat as a Dvaitin or a Vishishta, anything other than Advaita is Dvaita. So, Dvaitin means anyone who does not have Advaita Shastra Samskara is a Dvaitin, whether it is a Shunyavadi or whoever, we can categorize that. But we prefer to look at those who consider as Prapancha as real. Is it real? Yes. Then you are all in the first category. because of the reason given as Advaita Shastra Samskara Rahitatvam. If Advaita Shastra Samskara is there, one follows that, then Jagat is understood as Mithya. Then Jnana is possible, then Aikya is possible. Mithyatva Nishchaya Purvakam Advaita Jnanam. You cannot have Advaita Jnana and not have Mithyatva Nishchaya. That is not Jnana. Therefore, Mithyatva Nishchaya is definitely a mandatory factor in Advaita Jnanotpatti. Thereby, Sarasad Vilakshana Anirvachanyatvena Ajnanam Bhati. As long as this Jnana is there, in Vyavaharika, Nishtha isn't there, it will be seen as Mithya. Ajnana and its Karya, Jagat. Then when Jnana Nishtha is attained, Nididhyasana is complete, then one becoming a Jivan Mukta is absorbed in the Atma Tattva so much so that there is nothing other than Atma. Therefore, everything even discussed as Mithya is not Mithya anymore, it is Tuchha, meaning Asat. So Sat, Sadasat Vilakshana and then Asat. This is the status of Ajnana and Ajnana Karya. What is this Asat? Shunyam Iti. So Tuchham Asat Shunyam Iti Trayaha Shabdaha Samanartha. Whether you call it as Tuchha, Asat or Shunyam, it is a synonym. So all these three are synonyms of each other. Tatha cha uktam panchadashyam chitradipe. And this is the discussion in the panchadashi also. Let's quickly go through it. Mayam cheyam tamo rupa tapaniye tadiranat anubhutis tatramanam pratijajnye shruti swayam jadam mohatmakam tachet chanubhavayati shrutihi. Avalagopam svashtatvad anantyam tasya sabravit itham laukika drushtyaitat sarvairapyanubhuyate yuktidrushtyatva nirvachyam nasadasiditi shrutehe nasadasid vibhatatvat nosadasichabadhanat vidyadrushtyashrutam tuchham tasya nitya nivrattitaha tuchha nirvachaniyacha vastavi chetya sautridha Nyaya Maya Tribhirbodhi Shrauta Yauktika Laukikaihi Iti. So there are these he skipped one. So 127 is skipped. So there are five verses that have been quoted from the Chitradipa. I think Chitradipa is the sixth chapter, if I'm not mistaken.
Yes.
So there Maya Chayam Tamorupa. It is Tamorupa Maya. In the Tapani Upanishad, it is mentioned there. And Shruti talks about this Anubhava itself. Discusses using Anubhava. Jada Mohatmaka. This is the Anubhava of Maya. Abala Gopam Spashtatvad Anantyam Tasya Sabravit. And this, it is expansive, vast. Entire Prapancha is Maya Karya. Even culturally, even children know. Even the illiterate. So Abala Gopam talks about the children as well as the illiterate. Know what is Maya. They use the term Maya for this reason itself. Ye sab maya hai. So, generally people talk about it. Everything can be discounted saying that this is maya. Maya sarvasya sambhavat. It is known even to a child, to an illiterate. Itham laukika drushtya etat sarvair apyanubhuyate. This is the anubhava of every laukika. Even an untrained has the anubhava. May not know how to analyze it. And culturally, they know in upbringing that this is all Maya, Ishvara Shakti, whatever they say. Yukti Drishtya, but if a person is literate enough to inquire into it, literate in the sense Shastra literate, not PhDs, Shastra literate. So Yukti Drishtya to Anirvachyam. If you inquire into it, vicharam na sahate. This entire prapancha, look at this magical existence. But then you inquire into it, it falls apart as having any existence. Anirvachyam na sadasid iti. It wasn't there, it isn't there now. Meaning not really there. So sat has been refuted, but due to there being an experience, you cannot call it asat. Therefore, sadasad vilakshana. So nasad asid, it is not there now. It wasn't there earlier. But still, vibhatatvat, there is a pratiti of this prapancha, maya maya karya. No sadasid cha badhanat. Same thing that we discussed. Had it been sat, there would be no badha possible, but there is badha, therefore it is not sat. And had it been asat, then there won't be vibhana, but vibhana is there. Vidya drishtya, once the jnana, yukti leads to jnana, once what is revealed by Shruti is understood well, using yukti manana, then vidya drishtya, jnana drishtya, shrutam tuchham, what is known, it is revealed as tuchha, tasya nitya nivrittitaha, because it is never there. In Brahma, it is inferred to be there, but it is not really there. As long as karya is there, karyanumeya maya is to be inferred only in the vastu which is there. Vasati iti vastu, that is Brahma. Brahma vinna kimapi nasti. But there is a pratiti of prapancha. How do you explain this? How do we explain this prapancha to be there when Shruti says it is advaita tattva? Brahma is nirguna. So you have to explain the karya somehow. Karya is explained by saying that it is an appearance due to maya shakti, which undergoes change. Some sort of change is explained. But this is all inference by the Shruti herself. When you land on the reality, vidya drushtya shrutam tuchham, it is prapancha is not there because its karana, maya, is not there. What is the underlying principle on which all this is superimposed? That alone exists, which is Brahmatma. So what are the three ways the maya appears to be, ajnana appears to be? That is summed up in the 130th verse, saying tuchha anirvachaniya cha vastavi cha iti asau tridha. Trivida bheda. So you see three types of bhedas there. For a jnani, tuchha maya. For a sadhaka, vyavaharika drishtya anirvachaniya. And for a dvaitin, vastavi. Asav nyeya, maya nyeya, should be understood tribhi bodhaihi shrauta yauktika laukikaihi. So laukikas, so dvaitins are considered as laukikas. Why? They consider the prapancha as real. So panchadashikara categorizes this dvaitins as laukikas. Because their goal is what? Their goal is maybe shastra, karmakanda, revealing the Vaikuntha, Kailasa, or any type of Swarga, Brahmaloka. So if you take any Dvaitin, whether it is a Shaivite or a Vaishnavite, their goal is still in the Saguna Brahma. Saguna Brahma Ishvara is Laukika, not Paramarthika. Laukika. Therefore, Laukika ihi vastavi, maya, vastavi, nyeya. Yauktikaihi, those who are using yukti, for them it is anirvachaniya. Vicharam na sahate, is it existent? No. Is it non-existent? No, I can't say that. I am still a sadhaka. I am trapped in this. I can't say that it isn't there and still continue to live the life the way I do. That is hypocrisy. But what is real then? Once the reality dawns upon you, what Shruti really is talking about, Shravata. Once you have the complete vision, then you know Tuchha. Itham Jivan Muktanam Tuchatvena Pratiyamani Ajnani Mohamapannaha Shunyavadinaha Na Paramapurushartham Labhante. So Sadhu makes a concluding statement that Jivan Muktas find this as Tuchha. However, through understanding the Prapancha and landing on Brahma, Shunyavadis do not land on Brahma at all. They land on only that Ajnana which is refuted, that Maya which is refuted. So if you look at it, Shunyavadis, without knowing what they are discussing, what they have concluded, if we look at Shruti, then they have just concluded on Maya. They have not concluded on Atma at all. They are considering this Prapancha to be not there. So far, so good. But then they have not landed on Atma. In other way, you know, in other ways of explanation, another way of explanation, what is said is that they throw the baby with the bathwater. So they have negated everything, including the subject who cannot be negated. Atma, which can never be negated, is negated by them. This is one way of looking at it. Another way of looking at it is what the sadhu says here. He says that they have landed on Ajnana, they have not landed on Atma at all. They have negated everything, but they have not landed on Atma, to let alone refute it. They have not landed on it. Moham apanna. They are confused. By refuting Ajnana, they think that Ajnana does not exist and they have landed on Ajnana as Atma. Anandamaya Kosha is Atma. Karana Sharira is Atma. They have not even gone the step further and seen that I who cognize it am real. This is another way of refutation of Shunyavadis. Na Parama Purusharthan Labhante Te. They don't land on Atma, therefore they won't get, they do not get this Shastra, Shastriya Moksha. They don't know what is a Parama Purusharta Moksha. They won't get because Brahma has to be known as Atma. That alone is going to lead to Moksha. Kintu Tuchcharupa Anandamaya Kosha Eva Atma Iti Vadanti. That is the Anandamaya Kosha being Atma as per Shunyavadis. So let's look at what the Tippanakara says there. I think we saw this other thing of the Kshanika, Vijnanavada, Khandana we have seen. Now Atma Chidjada Ubhayatmaka iti Bhatta Paksha api Asangataha. Why is the Bhatta Paksha invalid? We have seen in the Mula how the Shunyavad is refuted, but let's look at some details in the Tippana. Ayam andakara prakasha ayam purushastanu iti vachya ekatra vastuni chit jadaunshayoho virodhat ubhayaunshatvam angikritya na nubhavapi भव गोचरो किंतु जड़ांशो एव अनुभव गोचर न चेतनांश इति कथनं तु न युक्तम. I'm not sure what is this word here. उभयांशत्वं अंगीकृत्य, I think there is a typo here. अंश, it should be अंशौ न उभौ अंशौ. So it is उभयांशत्वं अंगीकृत्य न उभौ अपि अंशौ. Should be, there should be an anuswara here. So, Ubhaya Aunshattvam Angikrutya. First, what is said? Ayam Andakarha Prakashaha. Can you make such statement? It is valid in Vyakrana, but it has no meaning. You cannot say this Prakasha is Andakara. That is the kind of statement you make when you say Chit and Jadatmaka is Atma, Ubhayatmaka. You cannot have contradictory terms in the definition itself. It is equivalent to saying Ayam Purusha Sthanuhu. One of them has to be. Even we say, I am Purusha Sthanu is an example given by Vedantins also. I am Sthanu Purushaha. But there it is, by saying that it is by badha, saying that sthanu does not exist, only purusha does not exist, sthanu alone exists. But what are you saying? Purusha also exists and sthanu also exists. Sometimes purusha, sometimes sthanu. This is the bhana. That can't be right. Iti vachya ekatra vastuni chijjadamshayoho virodha. There is a virodha. Thereby, you cannot say, meaning bhattas say that atma is chidrupa and jadarupa as well. Prakash rupa, prakash rupa. That is not valid. Ubhaya aushatvam angikrutya. Ubhaya aushatvam angikrutya. Having accepted that, na ubhau api aushau anubhava gocharau kintu jadamsha eva anubhava gochara na chetanamsha iti kathanam tu na yuktam. If you accept that and then you say, no, I see jadatvam, you discount chetanatvam, or you say that I cognize chetanatvam and then I don't see the jada paksha, because he's shown, when do you see jada, when do you see as chetana? He says the Vedantin is refuting by saying that you cannot say that jada anubhava is there and chetana anubhava isn't there. If you accept that, it is ubhaya ubhayatmaka. If his jada ansha is known, then chetana cannot be missed if it is of the type of having both attributes. Swarupa, not attribute, swarupa. If it is chit swarupa as well as chetana jada swarupa, chit swarupa and jada swarupa, as and when you are cognizing, or as and when you know, have anubhava of jada swarupa, that time you have chetana swarupa anubhava also, and vice versa. How can you separately do analysis saying that this is how it, I know that it is jada and this is how I know it is chetana? You cannot have separate experiences missing the other when you agree that they are having both in the swarupa, both aushas. That is meant by this sentence, ubhaya aushatvam angikrutya na ubhau api aushau anubhava gocharau kintu jadausha eva anubhava gocharaha na chetanausha iti kathanam tu na yuktam. यथा दंड दर्शन मात्रेण अयम दंडी इति ज्ञानम न जायते किंतु दंड पुरुषोभय दर्शनेनैव जायते तथा जडांश मात्र दर्शनेन न चिज्जड उभयात्मक आत्मसिद्धिर् भवति और भवेत. सो दिस वुडंट बी पॉसिबल. लाइक इन द एग्जांपल, इफ यू सी, लुक एट द दंड. दंड इज केप्ट देयर. द दंडी इज अ सन्यासी. सो दंडी सन्यासी. How do you say that? I am dandi. This person is a sannyasi. Why? Because he carries that danda. Sannyasa danda. Dandana darshana matrena yatha ayam dandi iti jnanam na jayate. Just looking at danda, you cannot say that there is a dandi purusha there. You don't see the dandi. And if you look at the sannyasi without the danda, you cannot say he is a dandi. You can say he is a sannyasi maybe. But not a dandi sannyasi. When you say dandi, then it is known as sannyasi also and danda carrying sannyasi. You have to see both danda as well as the sannyasi there. Iti jnanam na jayate, I am dandi iti. When you see only danda. Kintu danda purusha ubhayo darshanena eva jayate tatha. You have to see both. You cannot miss one and make a conclusion as having both. You cannot say that there are both and miss the other. So either way, you cannot make such erroneous conclusions. Chetanaushasya api anubhava gocharatva bhyupagame jadyam tatra kalpitam iti vaktavyam. But if you look at chetana, then chetana and jada cannot go together. Therefore, jada has to be kalpita. Jada is kalpita. Jada is not there in chetana. Hatad ubhayor aushayoho satyatva abhyubagame atmanah jada chetana aushayo parasparam kaha sambandha. But if you still argue that no, both are there, jada and prakasha aprakasha rupa, jada and chetana both are there, in the Atma Swarupa, then what is the connection between Jada and Chetana? You have to explain the Sambandha now. Since there are two. So in this Swarupa, if you have Jada Ausha and Chetana Ausha in Atma, Parasparam ka Sambandha. Mutually, how do they connect with each other? So this you have to talk about, you have to mention as to what is the Sambandha between Jada and Chetana Aushas of Atma. Sanyogova, Tadatmyamva, Vishevishi Bhavvaiti, Saprashtavyaha. So even if he still argues that no, Jada and Chetana Aushas are there, what is the connection between the two Aushas? Is it a Sanyoga Sambandha? Or is it Tadatmya Sambandha, Nitya Sambandha? Or is it Vishay Vishay Bhava? Is one Vishaya, other Vishayi? Chetana is Vishayi, you say, and Jada is Vishaya. Is that the Sambandha? Or they have become one, inseparable one, Jada and Chetana? Or they connect once in a while and have Sanyoga? Jada and Chetana. These are the three options given to the Purva Pakshi Bhatta. Adye Pakshe. If you say that, the first paksha. So now first paksha is Sanyoga. Second paksha is Tadatmya. Third paksha is Vishay Vishay Bhava. Sambandha. Vishay Vishay Sambandha. So Adhya Pakshe. When you say that, it is Sanyoga. Anityayoho Savayoho Dvayoho Vastunaha Eva Sanyoga Iti Niyamad Atmanaha Anityattvam Prasajyeta. Atma will become anitya if you say that there is Sanyoga Sambandha. Why? Because when is Sanyoga possible? Anityayoho Savayavayoho. There have to be parts. Wherever there are parts, it will become anitya. Now, anityayoho Savayavayoho Dvayoho Vastunaha Eva. Not Vastuna, not Vastunoho. So, there are two. So, Savayavayoho Dvayoho Vastunoho Eva Sanyoga Iti Niyamat. There is a rule. You are arguing using Nyaya, Tarka Shastra, then understand this, that you cannot have Sanyoga Sambandha. Sanyoga Sambandha is possible only between two Anityas which are having parts. Then if you agree that let them have parts, let them be Anitya, then Atmanaha Nityattvam Prasajyeta, not the parts. The parts being Anitya, the whole is also Anitya. So Atma becomes Anitya. If Atma is Anitya, what kind of moksha? Who will get moksha? Same issues which we have refuted earlier. So Bhatta Mata also falls into the same issue if you say that it is a Sanyoga Sambandha between Jada and Chetana. Aunshas of Atma. Dvitiya Pakshe. If it is Tadatmya Sambandha, that is a Dvitiya Paksha, then what will happen? Tijjada Aunshayoho, Chijjada Aunshayoho, Ubhayoho Api Ekasyeva Atmanaha Swarupatvat Chidaunshaha Jadaha Bhavet. Jada Aunshascha Chid Bhavet. If it is a Tadatmya Sambandha, there is an identification between the two. Nitya, Nitya Sambandha is there. If you say that kind of a Sambandha is there, between Chid and Jada, then how will you differentiate Chid and Jada? You have never seen them apart at all. Either it is Chit or Jada. If you say Chit is Jada, Jada is Chit, then what will happen? Chit will have Jadattvam, Jada will have Chetanattvam. Ridiculous. Tritiya Pakshe. So this is impossibility. You cannot make such statements. It does not stand. You know, it does not stand scrutiny. It does not stand the counter of logic, analysis of logic doesn't stand. Therefore, Tritiya Pakshe, you have to land on the third paksha. If you land on the third paksha, which is third paksha, is what here? Third paksha, you look at it, Saprashtavya, Vishay Vishay Bhava. If you say one of them is Vishaya, other is Vishayi. Generally, Vishay will be Chetana. It cannot be. The Jada having chetana as vishaya. So it will be only one way, but then anyway, this is an argument. So tritiya pakshe ghatata jnanavat ubhayoho aushayoho anatmatvam bhavet. Both will become anatma, not atma. Ghata tajnanavat. Ghata and tajnana. Ubhayo aushayoho anatmatvam bhavet. Why? Because they are part of one. Ghata and its jnana. That is taking place for someone else. But here you have both in one atma. If you say that, then you cannot have that possibility also. Vishay vishay bhava within oneself itself will make it anatma. Anatmatvam bhavet. Vijnanam anandam brahma, prajnanam brahma, satyam jnanam anantam brahma, ityadi shruti prasiddha jnanamatra swarupasya atmanah ardhamshasya jadatvabhyupagame pramanam naupalabhyate. So, apramanatvat. Darshana does not stand scrutiny at all. It is all svakapola kalpita. There is no pramana for having jadatva and chetanatva together. No shruti talks about that. Vijnanam anandam brahma is the lakshana vakya. Prajnanam brahma is the lakshana vakya. Satyam jnanam anantam is the lakshana vakya. Where is jadatvam there? Vijnana shows there no jadatvam. Ananda. Prajnana shows chetanatvam. Satyam. Jnanam. Satyam does not show jadatvam. Jnanam. Anantam. All these words do not have any connotation of jadatvam. Pramana is not there. Suptotitasya jadaha nissanyaham aswapsam iti atmanaha jadatva sampadika yasmriti yukta sas saushupta jnanam ye vishayi karoti. Then what about this question, sir? Asked the Purvapakshi. I slept like a log. That was the basis on which you have concluded. So that is explained. Jadaha nissanyaha aham aswapsam. I did not have any sanya there. Jadaha, I was jada completely. Slept like a log. There you have just objectified the kosha. Like the madhyamika. Iti atmana jadatva sampadika yasmriti yukta. The recollection of sleeping like a log. Sa saushupta ajnanamya vishayi karoti. You have cognized your own ajnana. So you know the ajnana being there. You are chetana there. You know the ajnana being there. Ajnana is not part of you. So you have misunderstood the jadatva. Jadatva is mithya. Chetana is the swarupa of atma. Tasmad atmana jada chetana ubhayamshakatvam asangatam eva. So it is not possible to have both. Jada amsha is mithya. It is an object for the deep sleeper who is chetana swarupa atma. So you have cognized your anandamaya kosha, which is karana sharira, which is ajnana or avidya, not, and that itself is jada and aprakasha, and not atma, which is chetana swarupa. That is your swarupa. So you have also misunderstood atma. Then we look at the shunya vadi matakhandana next. We'll stop here. Sukham nityam saprakasham vyapakam namurva adhishthanam buddhya bodhyam buddhyerdrukyatvanim aparam sarvedant vedyam pratyak paramah tadevahannam attonyat iti me nishchitamatihi. Any questions? Namaste, I'll see you in the next part.
Hari Om.